गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ टुडेज लेक्चर. टुडे वी विल सॉल्व द डाउट्स. एट फर्स्ट लेट मी आस्क हाउ वाज द पेपर. आई होप इट वाज वेरी नाइस. ओके सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ द प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग. ओके सो विल स्टार्ट विथ प्रॉब्लम नंबर वन. प्रॉब्लम नंबर वन वाज अबाउट द डायलेक्ट्रिक कॉन्स्टेंट एंड कैपेसिटर्स. This is K1, this is K2, and this is K3. And they have told that if I have to use only one dielectric, what will be the effective dielectric constant of that dielectric if I have to use the same capacitance. So as in first case, you must see that in first case, area is constant, है ना? Okay, area is constant over there, and distance is taken d/2. Because this, if I'll consider the separation, area is same, na? No, area is also a/2, sorry. Because area they are using this, na? This and this. So if you'll see like this, this is our distance. So if I am dividing this, then area will get divided a/2, a/2. And if I am doing like this, then what will be there? Distance d/2, d/2. So in first case, you may take directly, there is no problem. You may take area to be for this. See, area, there are two, na? Here, you see, first case, they are showing like this. This only you see. First case. So this you don't see. That afterwards we'll see. This will be 1. And this will be 2. So here distance has separated. So area will come. Area is A only. And distance will be d/2. And in second case. While taking these 2. That will be possible. But in first case, while calculating that, you will consider this. This only you consider. And it is divided like that. So for K1 and K2, calculating their effective, you will use a/2, a/2 and d/2. So, simply doing that, directly, you may do like this. What you do? C1, C2 and C3. First of all, you calculate their capacitance. And then, you may do this 1 and 2, take them in parallel. And it is like this, take them in series. So, once you are getting like this, take in series. And once you are taking like this, take them in parallel. Okay? This is our case. So, if I will call this K1 and K2, okay? So for C1 will be A. Abhi, now while calculating this, plate area is this, but for this plate area is a/2. So you take a/2 ε₀ k₁/d/2. Are you getting my point? So lastly it will come 2 will get cancelled. a₀ k₁/d. C2 same. a/2 ε₀ k₂/d/2. That will be a₀ k₂/d. But while calculating C3, what will take? C3 ke liye beta. For C3, what it is there? For C3, the case is like this. Area is A and distance is only d/2. So For C3, you will write A epsilon naught K3 upon D by 2. That's why it will come 2 A epsilon naught K3 upon D. So actually no need to do that. We are having tricks for that. I told you na what to do in series and what to do in parallel. So for parallel, directly add. Okay. So what is the hint? For parallel, directly add. And for series, what you have to do? Series ke liye beta, multiply by 2. Ye. So abhi kya karenge? CP means parallel of both. CP will be C1 plus C2. So this plus this. A epsilon naught upon D will be common. A epsilon naught upon D will be common. And I will write K1 plus K2. And for CS. CS means this total and this. So I will call CP into C3 upon CP plus C3. But no need to write this. I do have the formula. Na? So I can directly write like that. 2k1 k2 upon k1 plus k2. Are you getting my point? 2k1 k2 upon k1 plus k2. Why 2 is coming? That I have explained here. 2. So I can write instead of that 2 factor is there. Na? So a epsilon naught k3 upon d. So what I will do? I will take a epsilon naught upon d common. Okay. Here 2. K1 plus K2 into K3 upon K1 plus K2 plus K3. Okay. And now, this will be my common. Na? So, I want only, so this will be my K effective. Now, you have to split that K effective in such a way that it will be coming as your option. Okay. So, what is the option given? Okay. So, what you can do is that you have given option in 1 upon k like that. Na? So, actually what is the formula? Actually the formula is 1 by CS is 1 by CP plus 1 by C3. So, you may do that also. So, whatever is coming, na, just you do 1 by CS is equal to 1 by epsilon naught upon D is equal to 1 by this all. So, 1 by 2k1 k3 plus 2k2 k3 upon k1 plus k2 plus k3. Now only thing is that your k effective will be this and you have to split that k effective in your given format. Okay. So I think instead of doing this all, you may directly do using the formula. So, sometimes you may use that formula, sometimes you may use this formula. Okay, I have given you explanation because right now the question was like this. But the question may come directly also. 2k1, k2 like that also option they may give. But here they have not given the option directly like that. So, they are giving in the form of 1 by k and all. So, that's very simple. So, what you will write? Just like we did 1 by c is 1 by cp plus 1 by c3. That is 1 by CP. CP is how much? This. A epsilon naught upon D into K1 plus K2 plus 1 by C3. So 1 by A epsilon naught upon D into 2K3. Now you would have got the idea. 1 by CS is what? 1 by A epsilon naught upon D into K effective is equal to 1 by A epsilon naught upon D. That will be common. And here it is. 1 by k1 plus k2 plus 1 by 2k3. So you have got the option. You check the option. So option is given over there. I hope you have understood this. Okay. So do this. We'll go for the next part. So friends, let's go for next problem. Next problem is also same. Only now they have given capacitor like this. Problem number 2. They have given the capacitor like this, in which they have divided this. So K1 and upside it is k2 and downside it is k3. Now nothing to make it special. A will be this and this will be d only. So here it is a by 2, here it is a by 2. For this it will be d and this will be d by 2. Okay, so now options are not given, means we have to calculate that. Okay, so first of all let me take what is a, given. A 1 centimeter square, d 2 millimeter. So 1 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter square, centimeter square to meter square, and millimeter 2 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter. Okay, k1 4, k2 6, and k3 2 is given. Okay, let me check whether k3 is given 2 or minus 2. K3 take 2. So k1 is how much? 4, k2 6, and k3 2. K1 4, k2 6, and k3 2. Okay, now and what they are asking, find the capacitance across points A and B. So we have to calculate C equivalent, and C equivalent is equal to question mark. So now see, this may you may consider as this as C1, this as C2, and this as C3. So let me show you what is the case. C2, C3, and C1. So what we have seen, once you may do like that, okay, then you will get the idea. It is like that. Here is 2, here is 3, here is 1. So 2 plus 3 means 2 and 3 series is in parallel with 1. Are you getting my point? 2 and 3 series is parallel with 1. In prior case it was opposite of that. So what you will do, first you will write CS is equal to CS. How you can get it? CS you can get it as, for this C2 C3 upon C2 plus C3. Okay, but here the thing will be that while taking here d by 2 and a by 2 is there, so it is better to write 1 by CS is equal to 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3. So 1 by CS kitna aayega beta? 1 by a epsilon naught upon d into what you will write, KS you write for this. So I will directly write now, 1 by a epsilon naught upon d, this will be 1 by K2 plus 1 by k3. Okay, but now here a by 2 and d by 2 both are there, that's why I have not written. Actually it is here a by 2, d by 2, they will cancel, that is why it is okay. So my ks I am getting, ks will be directly 1 by ks will be k3 plus k2 upon k2 k3. So ks will be k2 k3 upon K2 plus K3, there is no problem. Now, for second stage, you can go with, now we did series, we did series. Now we have to do parallel of this CS and this. So, now let me write what is my CS. CS is my A epsilon naught upon D, whatever we calculated prior. K2 K3 upon K2 plus K3. Okay, so this is my KS. Now CP will be my C equivalent. So C equivalent will be my CP. CP of K1 and this combination. So K1 is C1. So C1 plus CS. Okay, so CP. CP will be what? A epsilon naught upon d into k effective, okay, is equal to okay, so no need to write it directly, you may do that Cp is equal to C1. C1 is what? C1 is A by 2. See, huh? Properly. A by 2. A by 2 epsilon naught K1 upon D, not D by 2, D is total. Plus Cs is how much? Actually, it is A by 2 epsilon naught Ks upon D by 2, but A by 2 and D by 2 are there. That is why I can directly write A epsilon naught Ks upon D. So, what you may do, Cp, you may do A epsilon naught upon D common. Here you will write K1 by 2 plus Ks. There is no problem now. You are having area. You are having area. It is 10 raised to minus 4. Epsilon naught 8.8 into 10 raised to minus 12. Divided by distance 2 into 10 raised to minus 3. Multiplied by K1. K1 is how much? 4. So 4 by 2 is 2. Ks. Ks will be K2, K3. 6 to the 12 upon 6 plus 2, 8. 12 by 8. So 12 by 8. So that will be 3 by 2. So all together 2 to the 4 plus 3, 7. 7 by 2. So this is 8.8 upon 2 into this 7 by 2 into now 10 power. 4 plus 2, 6. And this 3 will come. Minus 3 will be plus 3. So 10 raised to minus 3. So if you will all calculate this. So this will become 4.4 and this will become 3.5. So on average, if you do 4, 3 is 12. So 12 to 15 something, your answer will come. So your answer, and here millimeter to meter I have done. Everything is there. Yes. It is, sorry, it is minus 12. Na? So 10 to the power, it is 12 plus 4. So it is minus 13. So once you will adjust, you will get the answer. Let me give you the answer. 1.56 into 10 raised to minus 12. So this multiplication will come 0.156 into 10 raised to minus 13. Okay, so 15.6 into 10 raised to minus 13. So 15, you can take shift one decimal here. So it will become 1.56 into 10 raised to minus 12. So minus 12 means picofarad. So in this way, this can be done. Note it down, we'll go for the next problem. Okay, beta. Now let's go for problem number 3. Okay, problem number 3 is, the capacitance 884 are connected in parallel across a source of 120 volt. It's very simple. 884. Three capacitors are parallel. And source is how much? 120 volt. So 8 microfarad and 4 microfarad. Total charge on the effective capacity. Okay, so Q total, it's very simple. Q is equal to Cv, so C equivalent into V, that will be C equivalent. C equivalent addition of this, so 8 plus 4 into 10 raised to minus 12 into V is 120. So 20 into 120 into 10 raised to minus 12, 24 0 0 10 raised to minus 12. Okay, so charge they are asking, na? So millicoulomb, microcoulomb. Okay, so micro means minus 6, na? Ah, yes, minus 12, minus 6, sorry, this will come minus 6 because it is micro, na? Microfarad. So it's very simple. Here micro, na? So there is no option of 2400. So you have to convert 1, 2, 3. You may do 1, 2.4 into 10 raised to 1, 2, 3 it is there. So minus 3 it will come. So your answer will be 2.4 millicoulomb. So let us check that. Answer will come 2.4 millicoulomb. It is there. Okay. Let's go for the next problem. You write that. pause the video and write it. Okay, fine. Now the next problem. Next problem is 5 capacitors. Okay, they are connected like this. A, C, B, D. Okay. This is of 10 each. So I will write 10, 10, 10, 10, 10. Okay. The equivalent capacitance between the point A and B. It's a very simple. You are knowing that. Whenever this circuit is there, it is called as a balanced resistance bridge. So effectively, you are knowing that. I have given direct answer also. Whenever you are having like these same capacitors, C, 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 irrespective of this. So this have to cancel and the capacitance will be C. So the answer will be directly here 10 microfarad. You are also knowing that. So answer will be your 10 microfarad. Option number D. Let me check the solution. It will be same. Yes, 10 microfarad. Are you getting my point? I have explained that already in class also. Second also, fifth also the same. Fifth is same. Here only I will show you. Fifth is like this, na? This will also be balanced resistance meter bridge. Because this will be common and there are C1, C2, na? All are same. No, C1, C3, okay. C2 there is no problem. C1, C3, C4, C5, they are 4, na? So C1, this is 4, C3, C4. C5 and C3, there are 4 and this is 2. Anyhow, we have to neglect this. So this will become 4, 4, 4, 4. So lastly, it will come 4, 4, that will be 2 and this is 2. 2 parallel 2, 2 plus 2, 4. So again, it will come 4 microfarad. So this answer is also very simple. Okay, we'll go for the next problem, 6-1. Okay, let me check what is 6-1. 6-1 is, 6-1 will do. Let me check what is the time. Okay. 6-1 we will do. 6-1 is very simple. Only you have to use your brain. Solution is already given. So those who are not able to understand, they may get it from the solution. But it is better to see the lecture so that you will get the idea. So what is given over there? Aapko kya diya hai beta? Aapko diya hai. या ऐसे सर्किट दिया है तो सर्किट को पहले मैं कैसे ड्रॉ करते हैं बताता हूँ आपको. ओके, ऐसे दिया है आपको, बीच में 1 माइक्रोफेरेड है, यहाँ पे 2 है, यहाँ पे 2 है, यहाँ पे 2 है और यहाँ पे 1 है. सो 2 2 2 1 1 लाइक दिस है एंड इट इज ए बी एंड दे आर आस्किंग नेट कैपेसिटेंस. ओके, सो इट्स वेरी सिंपल. व्हाट यू टू डू बेटा, स्टार्ट विथ ए एंड गो देन. दिस इज 1, दिस इज 1 एंड दिस इज 2. सो फ्रॉम ए देर आर 3 कैपेसिटर. दिस इज 1, दिस इज 1 एंड दिस इज 2. दिस इज 2, सॉरी अपसाइड इज 2 ना, सो विल गो लाइक दिस. अपसाइड 2 इन बिटवीन 1 दैट इज डायरेक्टली गोइंग एंड दिस इज 1. नाउ after 2 there is one more capacitance of 2 and they are meeting at 1, and also after 1 it is directly going to B and 2 is also directly going to B. So 1, 2 and B and this 1 are directly connected. So you may do like that here 2. So 2 will be connected with this 1 and this B also, 1 and B. So this 1 is, so my B will be here. Are you getting my idea? B will be here, you know? So 1 2 2 1 2 2 they are meeting. So first of all, what you have to do, first take the equivalent capacitance, 2, 2, that will be 1, 1 parallel 1, 1 parallel 1 will be again 2. So I can write A, then here 2, okay, here 1, here B and here 2. So that 2 are now again in series. So 2, 2, that will be 1, and 1 parallel 1, that will be 2. So answer will come 2. So let us check. Yes, answer will be 2 microfarad. Question number 5. Oh, why they are telling answer 5 microfarad? 1 minute, let me check it. Oh, 1, 2 and 1. So, yeah, 1 plus 1, 2 microfarad. So, 2 microfarad is correct answer. Okay, because that I saw that problem number 5. This is problem number 6, na? Correct it is. Okay, so next problem, beta, what will do? At my lecture time, today my lecture will also be there, na? At my lecture time, I will take. Before that, let me explain you 7 and 8 and 10 also. 7, 8. From 9, we will go for next lecture. 7 mein kya diya beta? 7 में तो एकदम सिंपल है, 3, 3, 3 दिया है ना, एंड ऐसा उसको कनेक्ट किया ना, तो आई हैव टोल्ड यू ऑलरेडी वेन एवर दे आर कनेक्टेड लाइक दिस टेक ऑल इन पैरेलल इनको पैरेलल लेना, क्योंकि यहाँ से ए अगर बोला तो ए इसको भी कनेक्ट है, इसको भी कनेक्ट है, इसको भी कनेक्ट है, मतलब ए के जगह 3 भी है और बी के जगह भी ये भी कनेक्ट है, ये भी कनेक्ट है, ये भी कनेक्ट है. So they all are there. So 3 plus 3 plus 3, that will be 9 microfarad. Question number 8, there is no problem. Energy stored in charge conductor. Okay, half CV square will be the option. Okay, there is no problem. For 10 also, there is no problem. For 10, what you can do? Let me show you here only. So at least half of the paper we will discuss in this given time. Okay. So what will happen for 10? For 10, tell me kya diya hai? Amount of energy stored in the condenser becomes 9 times the initial energy. So U is equal to half CV square. So if C is equal to constant, C to constant rakha hai na humne, then U will be directly proportional to V square, or V will be proportional to root of U. Aisa bhi likh sakte hai na, isse V square likh sakte hai, 2U upon C. So V square will be proportional to U, and V will be proportional to root of U. So now V1, V2 upon V1 calculate will be root of U2 upon U1. Okay, so U2 kitna diya hai? U2 diya hai 9 times. U1 1 lene ka. So 9 upon 1, 3. So V2 will be 3V1. So option will be 3 times. So option A will be correct. Okay, fine. Next, all problems we will discuss in the next lecture. Thank you.